Hi from Toronto, my name is John Kyo, and welcome to another 10x10 series. This series, I'd speak with 10 experts for 10 minutes, and the focus is on Vietnam. We're going to talk about living, working, and doing business with Vietnam. And today I'm delighted to have with me Ms. Nha Ho from Blue Wave Advisory in Ho Chi Minh City. Good afternoon, good evening, Nha.
Good evening from Saigon, John. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, Nha. And you know what? The 10 minutes goes very, very quickly. So in the first minute, can you tell us a little bit about you and also a little bit more about Blue Wave Advisory?
Okay. So I would like to introduce myself. I'm the co-founder of Blue Wave Advisory, and our firm has been working for the last more than 10 years. In the corporate finance, M&A, fundraising for Vietnamese company and helping international company and investor to make investment and strategic investment into Vietnam. Myself, my background is very much in the banking sector, starting with the Deutsche Bank and Citibank back in 1995. And since then, I've been doing a lot of work for those banks, and also been working in the U.S. for also the same Citibank and J.P. Morgan. Lately, I came back to Vietnam and worked a lot in the investment side on the bonds and equity investment, and then also back to the bank sector. To in the management position for Vietnamese banks before we together with the other two founders set up Blue Wave Advisory Company. So our purpose is to connect and help Vietnamese enterprise and business owner to get funding to support their long-term growth in Vietnam.
Wonderful. That's great to hear. So, yeah, it sounds to me like you have been one of the first generation of pioneers bringing that banking expertise, and you're working overseas, bringing that knowledge and a new financial instruments back to Vietnam. What has that journey been like, that maturity from a very immature market to now, let's say in 2021? Has Vietnam made significant progress?
Definitely, John. And back then, actually, the market was very fragmented, and not many people even could speak English and communicate. And at the banking level, we actually really start to learn the expertise from foreign banks like Deutsche Bank and Citibank. And I was also privileged to get to be trained at those banks in Vietnam and overseas. So Vietnam has actually gone through a lot of change and growth over the last, especially over the last 10 years.
That's amazing. And I believe one of your colleagues, Vin, was the first chartered accountant in Vietnam. So are you seeing the level of financial literacy among companies mature, native Vietnamese companies?
Of course, we start to see from the Vietnamese companies, they start to lean on to proper accounting. And they start to use more international auditor of the Big Four in order to get their balance sheet, their financial reporting transparent and according to the international standard. So it's easier for them to get funding from foreign investors, and also to be able to list on the stock exchange later on.
Gotcha. Wonderful. Now, you also advise large foreign companies on how to enter the Vietnamese market. What is that conversation like, that first conversation when an international company contacts you and says, look, we want to do business in Vietnam. Either we want to do M&A activities, we want to do a partnership relationship, or we want to establish manufacturing. What are the first things that you discuss with that new client? What's really important to know about the Vietnamese market?
Very good question, John. I think being foreigners. When you work, you come into a foreign country, I think you have to really be able to position yourself where you are, what is your competitive advantages, and what is your long-term goal. And then when you have that perspective, you can really go in a deep a step further to see who are the players in the market and where either you can cooperate and or you have to really compete, meaning that either you do M&A and or you set up your business yourself. So in order to make that kind of decision, you need to people like us as their advisor to do market intelligence and to give the client the right picture of the market and also more about who are the potential partners or M&A targets.
Gotcha. And now, a lot of Vietnamese people, of course, speak English, but knowing English is not the only thing when you're looking at if an international company is coming over to Vietnam, and the fact that a Vietnamese company speaks English, that doesn't tell the whole picture. You need to understand the Vietnamese culture as well, right?
Absolutely, yes, that's very correct, John, because the Vietnamese, as you go to other country, I'm sure if I go to Canada, I have to rely on you. You need a local perspective. So the same work in Vietnam.
Yeah. So, and I think Vietnam is also similar to other countries in Asia where you may have on the same street, 10, 20, 30 vendors selling the same thing. Do you think the mindset is compete on price versus compete on value? And is competing on value or adding more value to products and services, is that something that's important to change in the Vietnamese culture?
Yes, we started from a very small and fragmented economy, right? So people tend to think short term, and you just put out a very strategic thinking that whether those people can think long term. And from my experience, I can see that now people, when they do business, they also choose to go on the sustainable route, rather than just one-off or opportunist type of business, and that's something that Blue Way very much into to support those clients, because we are the one who can help them to raise long-term funding from strategic investors.
Gotcha. Now, where are the key areas of growth in Vietnam that Blue Wave aligns to? So there are probably several sectors that are very much in focus right now. Which are the ones that are in focus and the ones that you help clients with?
We actually quite active in manufacturing, like in the steel furniture logistics. So those are the industry we believe that the core growth of Vietnam so far. Recently, we also focus on renewable energy like wind, solar, and rooftop, and also a bit more on the agriculture, sustainable agriculture. Because we believe that on that renewable energy, Vietnam have great support and incentive from the government, and it's been growing substantially over the last 4 years. And also it's go in together with the trend of sustainable growth in the world. So it's a good business to be in and to stay in the future. Logistics at the same time also help Vietnam's economy, because we are the trade country of export and import. So logistics is really the area that needs to be improved, and there's a lot of room to be improved.
Wonderful. Yeah, we have about 30 seconds left, but if you were up in front of a class of young female students in Vietnam, what would you tell the next generation of female business leaders in Vietnam? What should they focus on?
That my advice should be for them to try to keep learning, you know, and believe in themselves and keep learning. I think the world is so amazing, and if you keep learning, you will definitely find your place in there and you can be successful.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Folks, there you go. There you have it, all the way from Ho Chi Minh City. The 10 minutes goes very, very fast, but we're delighted to have you today. Nha Ho from Blue Wave Advisory. She's one of the co-founders. They help Vietnamese companies get bigger and better, and they also help foreign companies to get into Vietnam and understand the culture and the financial markets, the instruments to be able to do good business within the country. So, Nha, thank you so much for spending time with us, and have a great evening.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Take care.